Welcome to episode 47 of our Let's Play series. As you can see, I've been working on this. I think I like the shape like that. Maybe this is a bit too long, looking at what his length is, but it's the same, basically. But I think the arch is great, and it's just what I wanted. Then I was thinking about adding the stairs in the middle of it. Like this, but then a little bit wider. But that would take away how the how you can see the ease of everything. You can just see everything. But so I'm not keen about that, and I'm not sure about it yet. But I've been working on this system. So now when you press the button, the minecart goes through. We'll explain how that works, and then the minecart comes here, goes on top of all the hoppers, and then goes back and just pops bloop, to the corner. It can it's like sideways connected, if you know what I mean, because there is the rails right there. Maybe we can shoot a little bit more on top. The rails just goes like that, and it can go down, it can go up without a problem through the block. But down is a little bit of more problem. So what I did is I removed this block. So for example, can we activate this system still? Because I used this to test, yes. So for example, the block would be right here, but then a minecart needs to go through this block, and this block right here, this one, needs to be empty too. So what it does, it first pulls back the first one, and then the second one. So first this one pulls back, chasing this block. I should do it with sticky pistons, I don't have them, to there, and then it pulls it towards that one, towards that place. But when we activate it again, as you can see, the first one to activate is this one, then two ticks later this one, and then four ticks later, but that's already activated. This four ticks here is just to for pulling it back. So that works, so I can now remove this. I literally made this for testing out how this should work, because I'm a little bit out of the game. So that works fine, but then I thought, yeah, what should we do this upload? Let's press the button. And I'm like, nope, there is no button yet. So what we should do is make a button, and we would make it a good place to place it. Where is a good place? So I don't think that this looks keen. So we think we should change this a little bit. Maybe if you just add it so there was a hole here or something. How would that look? That the items just flow to this side. And then this would open or something. I don't know. We could do that. I don't know how much redstone room we have left. So let's dig a little bit away so we can see there's not much room left. This is the row we need to activate, which makes way more room than we already had. And there is this weird, oh yeah, this is a pillar. I'm sorry, I'm apparently having hiccups. This is the column for the water flow, because I changed that a little bit around this time, just so the water flows downwards and you can receive the items. So that's looking good, but I think If we manage, and I'm gonna do it soon, but let's just there, and a redstone is on top. Also, if you wondered how I did that, that's just a slap. So it's basically that block, this button powers downward, goes down, and because there's a slap right here, it has no problem doing so. But I think if you just, Do you still remember in one of the first episodes, we got right, does this still work? I don't think so. There was a button right here. Does not work. That's for sure. Let's take a peek. No, that definitely is away. It's not there anymore. Let's just keep the button there for everyone. For everyone who wonders, that doesn't do anything. But we had a double extender, and I basically removed this block right here with a double piston extender thingy. If you just get rid of this water, how to get rid of the water easily. If you see like that, and then like that, then we have quite a bit of the water away, but not all. No, I know. Let's do it like this. And I move this. So we are not going to be able to see the books in the water, which I don't mind. So it just goes along this side. And then we just add these planks next to the water again. Let's keep this one here temporary. But then we have a bit weird. You cannot see it then anymore, but it doesn't matter, bother me much. Then the water will go through here. Oh, and then we have a little bit of a different problem. Because if the water goes flowing through here, maybe what we can do, if you just remove this, if you only, bookcase, thank you. Like that, if we just so hang on tight. This is a fun ride. We could also just pop it out of the ground. How would that be? If you press a button, and we move it to here, and you press a button, and then it pops one out of the ground. That would be awesome, I think. We keep changing the plans, guys. I'm sorry. So then we just connect this one up to the place right there. Let's make the room a little bit bigger so we have some room to build. And then we place this one in there. And we move a little bit of wall here. So what we then do is we add a flow towards this place. Where's the staircase? I removed the staircase. I should not have removed the staircase. The recording messed up a little bit, but doesn't matter. Basically, let's get rid of the stones. You. Sometimes when I press certain keys on my keyboard in certain orders, some weird stuff happen. And apparently, yeah, it sometimes does that. We can remove this one. We don't need that anymore. We can move that, so that saves a little bit in wood cost. Not that we don't have enough oak planks or something, but yeah. So then we need a system that pops stuff out of the ground right here, and I would highly want if we pre-select what is going to happen. Is that a good idea or not? So for example, if we do it like we need cobblestone. We don't have cobblestone. I need cobblestone and a wooden slab. Oh, come on. We have it here. Nope, we don't have it there. We have it here. We need wooden slabs and some cobblestone. Is this the idea book? Yep. So, cactus. We already did that. We did another ceiling. We break through the nether ceiling. We did the guardian. Yes. We did the iron golem. Yes. So that's the stuff we already done. So I need to. I need to think about it. I need to make a room in this place where we can place the things we already accomplished. That would be nice. So we do that. Then when you press the button, it will activate that, and that would make a noise. So that would be a little bit worrying. So I was thinking about if we just so change the way this redstone signal works. So we change to slab, to block, and you connect it like that. I think, if you think differently, leave it down in the comments below. What would you do, what would happen if I press this button? Is that A, this will turn on, but this doesn't work? Or B, This will pop up. It will not pop up. That's nice. Then we also have a problem because this is air. We need sticky pistons for this. We have pistons, we don't have stickies. Let's run to our bases. I should also do something about torches. The torches are just here, so the monsters won't spawn, but that is not what I wanted from this base. So I need to change that some way around quite soon. But for now, here we have some sticky pistons. Do we have more redstone? Let's take some redstone blocks with me. Do I have some normal redstone things like that? Doesn't matter. So we're running back to the library, or what is going to be the library. I know there's two episodes behind each other doing the same stuff, but the library is a project and I think it's fun to work a little bit more on it. If you don't, just leave down in the comments below and I will think about it twice a second the next time. So what we now do is we send the pulse. Well, when we activate this one, the dropper, well, let me show you. So we'll place blank right here, fill it up. When we activate the dropper, the item will just... Oh yeah. Next problem. I wanted to show you how it works, and then it doesn't work. Because how Minecraft works. Look, then it just pops up like that. Now it's empty. But it basically would pop up, so let's put in a stack so we can see a little bit more. Do you have torches? Yes, we do have torches, so let's light up the place a little bit. Because last time I did not do that, I needed to rebuild the system because of a creeper. So when we push this, the item goes up, but when we did not have this piston, the item would just shoot out of this side. So we cannot use redstone right here. But we can use a piston. A piston can travel down, so it moves, and we can detect that movement. I should repair my picks quite soon, I think. So if we just send a non-stop signal through here, and then try to pick it up right here, it does not do that, because there is no block in between, because this is a block detector, as I used to call it. So if you now activate this one, you can see the power goes, and if you hear enough, you don't hear this one go, and this one still works, as you can see. So now we can activate the dropper without activating that thing. So now we want to have a comparator. We probably don't have comparators here, right? No, I don't think so. Oh, yeah, we do! So, what I would do is grab a lot of cobblestone out of this and just add redstone blocks? I don't know. So, we have a comparator. So now we're reading if there's signal right there. I want to have full strength. So now we have full strength right here. And should not interfere with the stairs. Nope, of course not. And if you do it like that, then it would wink. The only thing now to do is to send that wink to this thing. It is a little bit more. So if you just remove the stairs and then add a block, add a ring, and then just shift it over one block, then if it winks, yeah, we just add a block right here with the pulse, and then we can add a block. So now it shoots all the items that are in it upwards. We make a new stairs right here. That's nice. We can remove this one and remove this one and just grab that out of there. So if there's one item in there, it will shoot that up. So that's good. That's good. That's working. Then the only thing to do is to send this signal towards this one. We may want to have a little bit of bridge thingy. We cannot go lower than that. That's a little bit of a problem. We should go around. It's not a good idea. Then maybe go beneath it. go lower than it. Like that, and then we just add a cobble line and a redstone. So redstone wires cross but don't cross, as you get what I mean with that. So now when there's a block right there by the piston, the power will send to towards here. Be long enough, yep, it will send it to one of the things, and then would send an item out like this one. So we should start with hiccups. We should start with a witch. Is the description in here? Automated mob farm witch. Good description. Go away. And then I'll put it in some of these. Probably one of the first one, because those are still of wow. There's nothing in here. Why wouldn't not be there? If you just had a bunch of cards. Is there not enough power there or something? What's happening? There's not enough power. Alright. Doesn't matter. Just I don't want torch right there. Don't want that. Book and quill. What's the book and quill say? Underwater base. Yeah, good. So let's just grab a bunch. Remove this one. And put the books into the system. And we can check out why it didn't work. Maybe it's because of timing and such? I don't know. Did it work? No. It did activate something. What should not be. Ooh. Why would this be activated? Why? Oh, because why would it receive an update? Why would it receive an update? I have no idea why would it receive an update? Oh, because there's an item in there. That's why. Isn't that a problem? Because if there's no item in there, but a sick. Why does it do that? Why does it need to be that way? Why don't you float down? As it used to be. Like that. You know? What happens if we now activate the system? Why would you not flow downwards? Should we extend that pulse or something? Alright, so that's a little bit of problems, maybe. So the cake should be in there. And why always choose the cake? Why would it always choose the cake? I have no idea. I need to figure that out. So we put that in. Alright, so there's still some hiccups with the system that we need to figure out. Like, for example, why is this one still empty? Come on. Do we need to have it a little bit of like that, and then do we have no more rails? Yeah, we have no more rails. Good, 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 good. I didn't said anything. Let's just go one up, and like that. And then there is a little bit of chance it goes down, but let's just try that out. Anyway. Oh, please, let items flow in through here.
No! Why not?
Oh, I think I know, because this block, yeah, that's Ross's problem. Oh, my problem, my fault. So this redstone was powering the hopper, and that's why it didn't work. So now if we add a little bit in, come on, work, and then go to around the corner, and then one more of these. There. And then it needs to be powered. So that's not power enough for the whole thing, so let's just power it in the middle. And we still have no power right here, because... now we do. So now if we sand it, with items in there, we have some problems with our inventory. I'm really sorry about the problems with my voice. So we take a lot of books. Put them in here. And we send it off. So now it should put in items into this one. So that works. So I did two. So this one is full. I'm just making sure that it all goes a little bit of everything on the same amount. So you just put in stuff in here. That's basically, you have an idea, like a equip station. And you just press the button. It will save that to the storage. Ta-da! So now most of them are saved to the storage. Not all, apparently. Doesn't matter. Because you only are going to have one idea at a time. So you save that, and then it goes all empty. And you just put them into the draw press. So then we have this system. And it's looking for, if this one is empty, then we send the signal to that one, or to the next one, to choose. But if it's not empty, then it has a 1/5% chance of activating this one. And so on, so forth. And for the last one, it will always activate this one, if the one before had no items, or if that didn't choose, that didn't choose, that didn't choose, and that didn't win one, then this is going to be activated. So there is a chance. While I think about what's wrong with what's wrong with my voice, I'm really sorry about it. My apologies. So what's wrong with the system? So if this one is full but didn't get chosen, this one is full but didn't get chosen, just one, and this one is full but did not get chosen, and this one is empty. That would mean a little bit of problem. So what I'm gonna do is just take a lot of books out of this one and make sure the first one is the most full one of the whole system, the last one, because that one is going to be chosen when the system runs low. And that's why it's a good idea maybe to have also normal rails to turn the speed a little bit down. This is a good idea to start here, because the first book is going to be in here, and then the other ones. So now it's empty, but we can send it anyway, doesn't matter. And then what we wanted to do is to have the water flow up to here and then go down, I think, bum. Then we have the little problem that it needs to go in there. We may want to flip this around, so basically making sure that we have more space on the other side. So let's make a little bit of room. Oh, there's dirt here. I hate that. I dislike dirt. I don't like dirt. It's everywhere, you know. If you're playing like Skyblock or something, dirt is your best friend. That's, of course, it is that way. But in normal worlds, you know, it's not a good idea to have a lot of dirt around. So then we just flip this system over. You know the deal, you know the drill. This one, three of those with a fourth one, and then connect it like that. Then we can remove this part. Why we do this is because now we have clear entrance to this dropper. Basically, that's nice. So now the items that fall down right here, could we do that with dropper line? It would be easier, I think. Not easy, it would be not as good, I think. We could also, because if we press a button, this will not get activated, lower this by one, that make a drop line next to it. I would do that. And so what we do is lower this by one. Hole in the ground, ceiling. Come on, yeah. So and I'm place an hopper next to it, and then we'll do that between this one and the next episode. And then we add an hopper line right here, and we connect this hopper towards like this hole. So we have a watering hole like this, something like we place water on top of these wood planks. These wood planks you just put down like so. So now the items fall down here, so they travel to here, fall down, travel underneath the normal thing, and then on top of this hopper, and then it puts that into the chest. We need a second hopper, by the way. It will put that into the dropper, and the dropper will spit that upwards whenever there is an item. The only problem with this is that the dropper will get activated, so we need to move that one more down. No, we cannot. Well, I will think about it, but for now, I will think about it between the episode, and we'll make that finish, and may show you that next time. But basically, what's going to be the idea, if you have an idea what to do with in the Witcher's world, post it down below. I will put it into the Minecraft chest. I will put it through the system. It will get saved in these saving things. And then when I need an idea and I run out of the idea, I press this button and it will get one random book. No random book this time. Weird, let's try again. I hear an empty drop dispenser, that's right. But why is it not activating something? Activating the first one or something? No, it's not activating this one. Should activate. I should also check this system because I think there's a little bit of problem with it. But anyway, for now, thank you guys for watching, and I hope to see you another time soon. So for now, goodbye.